Coming up on today's Philadelphia Eagles Now, more Bijan Robinson draft buzz, and we'll get to the latest on Devin White and the trade rumors around him heading to Philadelphia. But before we get started, make sure you subscribe to us here on Eagles Now, because we're going to be going live for the entire first round of the 2023 NFL Draft. As of right now, the Birds slated with picks number 10 and number 30. We're going to be going live, breaking down who the Eagles are bringing in on draft night, and of course, some great draft analysis as well. Great super chat games. We'll be slugging some beers, having a party on night one of the NFL draft, which kicks off a week from Thursday. So go Birds, subscribe, and also we give you year-round content and daily shows on the Philadelphia Eagles. Let's begin today's show with the latest around Bijan Robinson. ESPN NFL draft expert Todd McShay has the Eagles picking Bijan Robinson at number 10 in his latest mock draft that he also did alongside Mel Kiper. And let's talk about Bijan Robinson here. He's really been a steady presence here on the show because I'm infatuated and I'm fascinated by the idea of the Eagles taking him. Here's my take on Philadelphia drafting Bijan Robinson with the 10th overall pick. The only negative about taking a running back at number 10 is the fact that Bijan Robinson is a running back. There are so many advantages with the Eagles taking Bijan Robinson with the 10th overall pick. He immediately makes the offense better. He is a great scheme fit alongside Jalen Hurts, and he is a cost-controlled, elite, transcendent weapon over the next 5 years. This is a really unique situation for Philadelphia because you think about it, right? How often is a team that makes it to the Super Bowl drafting inside the top 10? Extremely rare. Never. And the Eagles don't really have a big need on this roster because even though they lost a couple of pieces defensively, they lost Isaac Seumalo and Miles Sanders offensively, they don't have a lot of needs. But running back on this team is a need because Miles Sanders, for the first time last year, surpassed 1,000 rushing yards. He had a career high in touchdowns. He was a top five back in the NFL last year. He had 315 touches in 2022. Right now on the roster, the Eagles don't have a back that is capable of toting the rock that many times. But that's what Bijan Robinson does best. He can catch balls out of the backfield as a receiver. He can catch balls out of the slot as a weapon. He's extremely unique with how he's able to do that and also run the football in between the tackles, and he's able to get out to the perimeter. Bijan Robinson is a special, transcendent player, a great scheme fit, and what I think Howie Roseman should do, take the Ferrari. Why? Because offense wins in today's NFL. The two Super Bowls that the Eagles have played in recently, Super Bowl 52, Super Bowl 57, have both been shootouts. And Bijan Robinson helps you win in shootouts. Defense is obviously important. Offense has become more important and more paramount in today's offensive-laden era. And Bijan Robinson can affect the game in so many ways and can be an elite player over the next 5 years. And in my opinion, he's a top three overall football player in this 2023 NFL draft class. Here's what Todd McShay did have to say about the star-studded Texas back. And I think it's honestly disrespectful to just call him a running back. I think he's an all-around playmaker and weapon. Here's McShay. Look, I know he might not go this high, and we can spend hours talking about running back value in round one, but Robinson is my number two overall prospect and makes sense in this Eagles offense. He's a complete back who could dominate alongside newly extended quarterback Jalen Hurts in the backfield. So with that, let's shift gears to our poll question for today's show. You're making the pick. You're in the war room with Howie Roseman. Should the Eagles draft Bijan? Or if he does get drafted, as we're going to deem him here on the show because he's going to Philadelphia, Bijan. You see what I did there? D for draft, O for other. Let us know. Now, also, you have to think about this overarching question. Will the Eagles actually do it? Probably not. Why? Howie Roseman and this organization values defensive line and offensive line above all other positions, obviously, outside of the quarterback position. You look at the latest Eagles draft odds. This is how the odds makers expect the Eagles to draft at number 10. The leader in the clubhouse, they think they go offensive line, minus 175. Paris Johnson, Peter Skoronski, two popular picks there. Defensive line is obviously an option at plus 200. Cornerback, although I'd say bringing back Darius Slay and James Bradbury makes this somewhat unlikely, and then running back at plus 1,000. I honestly think these are pretty good odds because I do still think that maybe Howie Roseman can cave to the public pressure of Eagles fans and a lot of analysts saying, this is the smart pick. You don't have a lot of needs. Why not take the incredible player who can make a day one impact in Bijan Robinson? And look, I'm not the only one who's high on this prospect. Todd McShay has him as number two on his board. And a guy like Joel Klatt also thinks that he is a top five player in this class. So we could turn to the experts, although I think I'm right up there with some of the experts with some of my opinions and analysis. Robinson is quite simply the most dynamic and best non-quarterback offensive player in the draft, Klatt said. That's the best way I could put it. Whoever drafts him is going to get a dynamic, game-changing athlete. I think he's very much in the same vein as Christian McCaffrey. And you know what? I compared Bijan Robinson to Christian McCaffrey a couple of weeks ago. People called me crazy. Now, I think Bijan's a better runner. I think that he can honestly be a better player. Why I made that comparison, both of those players can impact the complexion of the game, running the football and catching the football, not just out of the backfield, but also as a slot wide receiver. Peter Schrager, NFL Network, friend of the show. Also, has the Eagles taking Bijan at number 10? That's why this draft buzz is hot right now. I know the Eagles haven't drafted a running back in the first round since the 1980s. Keith Byers, by the way, there's your chat stats portion of the show. I also know there aren't many elite players in this class. Robinson is one, pure and simple. And that's really what it comes down to. If the Eagles are going best player available at number 10, they would be hard-pressed to find a better player at number 10 than Bijan Robinson. He is simply that good. He is simply that special. He is a transcendent player who is cost controlled over the next 5 years. So even if you run him into the ground, that's fine. Super Bowl window is open over the next 5 years. The Jalen Hurts cap hits are small over the next 5 years. Bijan Robinson makes a lot of sense. Very excited to welcome a brand new sponsor on board here on Philadelphia Eagles. Now it is ZBiotics. A sponsor that really, really helps me recover from some of our live shows and some of our watch parties because, as the real ones know, things can get crazy. Shout out to the real ones, too. I'm rocking the real ones shirt today. So, ZBiotics, let's face it. If y'all hit me with a bunch of super chats, I don't really bounce back well the next day because I'm 31 years old. That is until I found ZBiotics. ZBiotics, pre-alcohol probiotic, is the world's first genetically engineered probiotic. It was invented by PhD scientists to tackle rough mornings after drinking. I know all about that after my vacation in Key West. ZBiotics helped me bounce back. Here's how it works. When you drink, alcohol gets converted into a toxic byproduct in the gut. It's this byproduct, not dehydration, that's to blame for your rough next day. ZBiotics produces an enzyme to break this byproduct down. It's designed to work like your liver, but in your gut, where you need it the most. Drink ZBiotics before drinking alcohol, and of course, drink responsibly, and get a good night's sleep to feel your best tomorrow. Give ZBiotics a try for yourself by heading to ZBiotics.com/chatsports, and you get 15% off your first order when you use the code chatsports at checkout. ZBiotics, backed with a 100% money-back guarantee. So, Eagles fans, if you're unsatisfied for any reason, they'll refund your money, no questions asked. Remember, head to ZBiotics.com/chatsports, code chatsports at checkout for 50% off. Thank you to ZBiotics for sponsoring today's show. You have ZBiotics, you drink responsibly, you don't have a hangover, and you enjoy tomorrow. We'll put that link in the comment section and in the description of this video. Now let's round out the show by getting to the latest on Devin White here. According to reports, and we talked about this several weeks ago in the build-up to this, White has reportedly requested a trade from the Tampa Bay Buccaneers because he is unhappy with his current contract situation. Heading in to the final year of his deal, set to be an unrestricted free agent in 2024. And if he reaches free agency, given his age and the caliber of player, he is going to be sought after by a lot of teams across the NFL. What's interesting here is that Devin White was sent this picture on Twitter, a jersey mock of him rocking the midnight green. It also had a screenshot of when he was in the comment section for Greedy Williams upon signing with Philadelphia earlier in free agency, when Greedy had the Instagram caption, Philly with the bird, and then Devin White said, let's make it happen. He's also liked a couple of tweets linking him to the Philadelphia Eagles, and then he quote tweeted that picture by saying, green is my favorite color, but 40 and 45 are my jersey numbers. I do appreciate the love. There's been a little bit of traction, some paper trails following Devin White and his potential interest in the Eagles and the Eagles' interest in him. Here's what Bucky Brooks, who used to be an NFL scout, now works for NFL Network, had to say about White heading to the Eagles. He listed Philadelphia as one of the top destinations for the star-studded linebacker for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. He said, talk about the rich getting richer. General manager Howie Roseman is certainly no stranger to wheeling and dealing. Despite the Eagles' reluctance to pay big bucks for off-ball linebackers in the past, they could see White as a key ingredient to a championship-caliber defense. The veteran would give Philly another playmaker to feature as part of a new dynamic pressure package under defensive coordinator Sean Desai, and White could add a new dimension to a defense with a deep and talented rotation along the front line. And that Eagles front line on that defensive line is spectacular. And at that linebacking core, some question marks. Is N'Kobe Dean going to step in for T.J. Edwards, who got $12 million in guaranteed money from the Chicago Bears? You also lost Kaiser White, who followed Jonathan Gannon to the Arizona Cardinals. None of those players the caliber of Devin White, who has certainly lived up to the billing of being the fifth overall pick back in 2019 out of LSU by Tampa Bay. In 2020, year two sophomore campaign, named a second team All-Pro. In 2021, he was a Pro Bowler. He has played in 62 games, 62 starts, and elite, and I mean elite, side line to sideline speed. There are a couple of linebackers in today's NFL where sometimes I think you're doing yourself a disservice if you don't just watch them play the game of football. I know everybody likes to follow the football. It gets snapped to the quarterback. You want to see where the quarterback throws it. Sometimes you like to watch the line play too, because that can change the feeling of a game. But you're doing yourself a disservice if you don't watch solely and individually guys like Devin White and Fred Warner to just watch how they react to what's happening against the opposing offense, and just watch some of their speed and how they are just able to wreak havoc with some of that elite athletic ability and the diagnosing skills. Now, I think Fred Warner a little bit better than Devin White, but the point here being Devin White, really, really good player who is a joy to watch in the open field and can affect the game in a variety of ways. I mean, look no further than his stats over the last 4 years. In three of the last 4 years, in three consecutive seasons, he's racked up more than 100 tackles. So you can at least count on him to be a guy who's a very good tackler. But what's unique about Devin White, and this is where he is better than a guy like Fred Warner, is Fred Warner is a traditional off-ball linebacker who doesn't really get active behind the line of scrimmage. He's more so active against the run and against the pass. Devin White, on the other hand, can be included in a lot of blitz packages, and Sean Desai, hopefully aggressive because he's a Vic Fangio disciple, and he can send Devin White home on some of those blitz packages. 16 quarterback hits in 2020, 18 more in 2021, and 16 more in 2022. Goes to show you the unique usage that he can be a part of in Sean Desai's defense. Here's the thing with Philadelphia as for why it might make sense and why it might not make sense. Devin White is unhappy with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers because they haven't given him a long-term deal. I don't know if Philadelphia would be willing or if they have the assets or the money to give him a long-term deal. But could they make a deal like they did for C.J. Gardner-Johnson, a one-year rental for a team that has Super Bowl aspirations? That's possible. That's possible for sure. Devin White, $11.7 million cap hit in 2023. That is affordable for Philadelphia this year if they're looking to upgrade that defense and bring in a player who's won a Super Bowl, who's been a part of a Super Bowl run, who is a very good player still in his prime and somewhat affordable at that cap hit of nearly $12 million. So with that, we're going to round out the show with this. Your level of interest in Devin White is what? Scale it for me from 1 to 100. Make sure you turn on your notifications and subscribe, because in the days leading up to the draft, a lot of stuff could pop off. And another reminder, subscribe to the show going live for the entire first round of the NFL draft a week from Thursday.